who know how to pray and talk to God to appoint the next leader. But the problem is we have religious constructs and systems that are set up to where the deacons seem to run the church and make all of the decisions. Turn with me to 1 Samuel chapter number 8. I'm going to read a couple of verses within this. We're not going to park there, but I'm going to read a couple of verses, and then we'll get into the meat of where we're going, okay? 1 Samuel chapter number 8. You don't have to stand. I appreciate it because I'm going to be reading, and you might be standing up too long. But I respect the house, and I understand. 1 Samuel chapter number 8, we're going to be reading to verse number 9. It says, and it came about when Samuel, and I'm reading from the Amplified, when Samuel was old that he appointed his sons and judges over Israel. Now the name of his firstborn was Joel, and the name of his second was Abijah. They were judging in Beersheba. Verse number 3. His sons, however, did not walk in his ways. This is why it's very important. Just because you have a son, that don't mean you appoint them to pastor because you're going to die. How many of us do that and the church fail? When the person that was appointed may not have been your blood son, but the spiritual one. I'm going to leave that alone. I want to get invited back. His sons, however, did not walk in his ways, but turned aside after dishonest gain, took bribes and perverted justice. Verse number 4, then all the elders of Israel gathered together and came to Samuel at Ramah and said to him, look, you have grown old and your sons do not walk in your ways. Now appoint us a king to judge us. And rule over us like all the other nations. Israel, listen, body of Christ, you're not like everyone else. Stop trying to be everyone else. The worst thing you can do is ask for something and God let you have it your way. Israel and the elders at that, who should know better, are asking Samuel, you give us a king, not because that we want a king. We want a king to be like somebody else. You weren't called to be like someone else. You were called to be set apart. You weren't called to sag your pants or dress like anyone crazy. You were brought up in a home that had respect and dignity. You're not searching for love outside. You're searching for love inside. And outside is only going to get you in trouble. We shouldn't be appointing people. We should have quality elders who know how to pray, not take bribes. We should have elders who not sitting around judging and holding the church shackled. We should have elders who know how to pray and talk to God to appoint the next leader. But the problem is we have religious constructs and systems that are set up to where the deacons seem to run the church and make all of the decisions. Oh. We should have deacons, but not control agents. God is in control. That's why they didn't have a king. God said, I will appoint one, but yet you want one. So guess what? I'm going to let you have it your way. Look at what it says here. In verse number 6, it says, but their demand displeased Samuel. So look at what Samuel was displeased. Why? Because anytime the man or the woman of God hears from God, they already know the heartbeat of God. So when you come with your foolishness, they're not going to sit there and take your side and you want to get mad. They're here not to please you, but to be God pleasers, not people ones. He says, the Bible says, but their demand displeased Samuel when they said, give us a king to judge and rule over us. You came out of Egypt with rulers over you. Now you come into a place where you have freedom and you want to go back to Egypt in your mind. We have people who are free but slaves in their mind. All because they want to be like someone else. Take your time, be patient. God is going to shift you if you wait and be patient. Stop making decisions based because you see the person next door get a new car and you feel you got to have one too. Make decisions based off what God is saying and not what people are doing. This is why we have people who open congregations and churches and go say, well, if they build it, they'll come. Yes, that worked in the movie because the man owned the property. That don't work for you if God ain't say it. If God said it, he gonna get provision for it. And it's not gonna be confusing to the people. Everyone is gonna be on one accord with it. Amen. Verse number 7, the Lord said to Samuel, listen to the voice of the people in regards to all that they say to you. For they have not rejected you, but they have rejected me from being king over them. Man, if I can have God king in my life, I would rather not have no man. If I could have God the manager of my job, I would have him. If I can have God in every aspect of my practical life, I would have him. I don't want people to tell me what to do. That's why I don't understand how people love going to jail. Get up at 3 o'clock. Go to sleep. You got to eat this. You got to do that. God gave them a free reign and ability to dwell in the wilderness, and God gave them manna from heaven. They didn't have to wait on somebody to cook food for them. It was raining food. And they complained. We tired of bread. Just like black folk, right? We hungry, and then we get fed. I don't like that. We tired of bread. Give us some meat. God said, okay, I'm going to give you quail. That was the biblical chicken. Because quail is in the family of the chicken. Guess what happened next? We tired of meat. Then they start talking about where they came from. When we was back in Egypt, we had watermelon. I'm not exaggerating. That's in the text. Melon, when you look at it in Hebrew, it's watermelon. We had watermelon. We had all kinds of good food back there. They free but want to go back to slavery. Why would you want to go back to a relationship that didn't work? You tired of being lonely? Get God. Look at what it says in verse number 8. Like all the deeds which they have done since the day that they was brought out of Egypt, even to this day, in that they have abandoned, rejected me, and serve other gods. So they are doing to you also. Pastors, don't find it strange, okay? Don't find it strange. Sometimes you got to do a little investigating. Sometimes you got to find out why somebody left a church. Goodness. Don't just be so caught up in wanting numbers. It's better to have quality than quantity. Sometimes you got to find out why did a person leave a place. This is why pastors need to have relationships and get out of competition. Pick up the phone. Hey, brother, why did they leave? Oh, they caused turmoil over here. He was sleeping with this woman and that woman, and we kicked him out the church. So that way I know when he come to our congregation, I can go ahead and talk to the brother and discern and find out what's going on, because it's important the better to have more than just discernment, because discernment can be intuition. You need to have discernment of spirits to recognize and understand what's coming into the body sitting amongst. Just because they throw up their hands in worship don't mean they ain't praying on somebody in the church. Be very careful. Be very careful. Make sure you know. It's not to embarrass them or put them on blast, but to have leadership meetings. Hey, this is what I heard about that particular person. They trying to bring Egypt over here. No, we got liberty over here. We don't need Egypt. So until he is delivered, make sure he ain't hanging out with sisters by himself. Got to protect these folks. Amen. Look what he says. Verse number 9. So now listen to their voice. Only solemnly warn them and tell them the ways of the king who will reign over them. So we're not going to read this, but you can write this down. 1 Samuel chapter number 15. Okay, 1 Samuel 15 in verse 1 through 16. That's going to talk about Samuel and how Samuel was given to them. He was the one. They wanted a king, so God gave him what they want. Yah gave them what they want. He didn't give them his choice. He gave them the people's choice. That's why you have to make sure that you have a Yah's man and not a y'all's man. They wanted a king like the other nations, so he gave them one. The other nation king didn't regard and care about people. They didn't love people. They only loved themselves. So they turned, God gave them a Saul, a Samuel. He turned around, I'm sorry, he gave them a Saul. He gave them a Saul, one who would do what? Do the same thing that the other nation's king did. To put their children in battles, took from the people, robbed them, hustled the people, belittled the people, and everything. Right? So let's jump over here. We're going to close. We're going to deal with this right here. 1 Samuel 16 is where we're going to park at. 1 Samuel chapter number 16 in verse number 1. The Lord said to Samuel, how long will you grieve for Saul? Now, when you read in the particular chapter before, you find out that Samuel gave Saul permission, gave him clear instructions when he deal with the king of Agag, do not keep anything from that particular place. I want you to kill it, destroy it, everything. And matter of fact, you kill him too. But what happened? Boy, that lamb look good. Boy, that look good. That car look good. That house look good. That furniture look good. God ain't going to trip about that. See, Saul made a decision because he didn't have a relationship with God like that. The prophet had the relationship with him. So guess what happens? He did the same exact thing the other kings would do. He went in and he took what he wanted and kept it. And then tried to hide. And tried to act as though he did the job that God told him to do. And so now the prophet who hears and sees what's going on. Yes, you might have it hid back in the cut. But God always have a seer in the body. So what you think you're getting away with, you're not actually getting away. You're just getting by. You know, we have secret sins. You're not getting away. You might as well repent of that thing. It's better for you to repent of that thing than for it to be exposed. Even in the exposing, God is showing mercy on you to stop from killing you. So exposure is also a blessing, even though don't make you feel good and comfortable. And you may lose friends and lose family, but thank God he didn't kill you in your sin.